We are starting a new topic today. So far we have studied that if a charged particle is kept in a magnetic field, it experiences a force if it moves. If it does not move, there will be no force, of course. But time and again, what we are discussing is magnetic field. Who creates this magnetic field? The source of magnetic field. That is our topic today. And now, in our topic, there will be source of magnetic field. So, source of magnetic field is very well, we know it. The moving charge or electric current is the source of magnetic field. Now, if electric current is our source of magnetic field, how much current gives how much magnetic field? We know the intensity of magnetic field as defined one unit as Tesla, that gives 1 Newton force to a 1 Coulomb charge which is moving with velocity of 1 meter per second. There is a force 1 Newton, then the intensity in this room is 1 Tesla. But who creates this 1 Tesla? The answer is current creates, moving charge creates, another moving charge, another current creates this 1 Tesla magnetic field, or 2 Tesla or 10 Tesla, whatever it is. But what is the relation between strength of the magnetic field and quantity of the current? If I am flowing here current I, how much should be the I so that magnetic field is 2 Tesla? So what is the relation between intensity of magnetic field and the electric current which is creating this magnetic field? Okay, for that, first time the law was made by B.O. Savas. So, we start studying it with B.O. Savas' law. B.O. Savas' law tells us the relation between a few quantities. What are those quantities? The strength of magnetic field created by current. So, there is a current and there is magnetic field. For that, we can take example that there is a conductor. In this conductor, current I is flowing. This is part of a conductor and current I is flowing here. If there is a current, there will be certain magnetic field. So, there is one point here, P, and there is a magnetic field created here. How much will be this magnetic field? For that he made a law. He says that the source of magnetic field is electric current, but here he defined that for flowing the electric field, a length has to be there. If there is no length, then how current will flow? A charge, unless a charge moves, it cannot make electric current. So, for making electric current, a charge has to move. If it has to move, then there should be some length of the path. Unless length of the path is there, charge cannot move. If it does not move, it does not form current. If it does not form current, it has no velocity, there will be no magnetic field. So, what is necessary? Along with charge, length of the path is necessary and the charge must move. Combined all these things. A charge moving makes current. Length of the path, I take here a very small length. Okay, just for the purpose, I am making it large, but this is a very small length, I call it dn. Now, when the charge passes through this, it forms a current because it's moving. Now, this current can create magnetic field all around it, and we want to find out what is magnetic field at this point. What is specialty of this point? What are the specifications of this point? This point has specification in two terms. What is the distance from this and at what angle it is? Now, first let me name it. The name of this length, we will call it as current element. And all such elements put together makes the conductor. So, this current element is the preliminary thing which is responsible to create magnetic field. So, in one word, who creates magnetic field? Answer, current element. Okay. This current element creating a magnetic field, I want to find out what is magnetic field at this point. What is specification of this point? This point is at a position R making certain angle theta with dl. Here dl is also having a certain direction, R is also having a certain direction, and angle between them is theta. Okay, this is specification. Now some magnetic field is produced here. Strength of that magnetic field, let us give that strength name dB. A very small magnetic field here. So we have named the things. There is a current element in which current flowing is I. There is a point B which is at a distance r, and this position vector makes angle theta with this dl vector. Now what is the magnetic field here? For this magnetic field, Biot-Savart made a law. So first, Biot-Savart clarified that what are the different quantities. These are the different quantities where he is going to establish relation. Now he says that this dB, this depends upon many quantities. Okay, this dB is proportionate to, if this length is larger, then strength of magnetic field will be more. If current is larger, then strength will be more. So this is proportionate to I, this is proportionate to dl, and this is inversely proportionate to the distance r. The more is the distance, weaker will be dB. And here he found out, or he calculated, or he copied Coulomb's law, that the strength of this magnetic field will decrease as square of the distance, what we call inverse square law. So he also said that this dB is inversely proportionate to square of the distance, just like Coulomb's law. Then he said that if this R is here, there will be certain magnetic field, but if I take this R here, this R, I find magnetic field here is different. It is stronger. Here it has become weaker, 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 weaker. At some point it will be zero. That means this theta has a great importance. It has a role to play. So this is affected by theta. If theta is 90 degree, he found it is maximum. If theta is 0, he found it is 0. And that is change according to sine theta. So he said that magnetic field at all r distances is not same. It is affected by angle also. And this dependency is dp is proportionate to sine theta. If it is at right angle, it will be maximum. If it is at 0, it will be 0. So these are the things, and he combined it. dB is equal to I dl sine theta upon r square. dB is proportionate to. Now to convert it into equal, we need a constant, the multiplication factor, and he said that this dB depends upon another thing, and that is a property of the space. When we were calculating electric field due to a charge, he was greatly impressed by Coulomb's law, that electric field is proportionate to, electric field is proportionate to or equal to source Q upon square of the distance r square. This is our formula for electric field. So source for electric field was Q, source for magnetic field is I dl. IDL we call current element. IDL, current element. This is source of a magnetic field, and R square, this R square. So his formula was affected by, or very much he was impressed by Coulomb's law. So he made it in this way. Now, to make it equal, there has to be a constant here, and he says when we make this equal, there is a constant which is 1 upon 4 pi, of course number, and this epsilon naught. What is this epsilon naught? This is permittivity of the medium. Permittivity, electrical permittivity of the medium, which is a quantity, gives certain electrical characteristics, whether it will allow the charge to apply force or it will not allow the charge to apply force. That is permittivity. The same thing, he says, there is another property in the space which allows magnetic field to be applied. And this magnetic field, because of this I, this magnetic field created here, that property of the space, that characteristic of the space will allow how much will be the magnetic field here. So, what is that characteristic of the space? He says that characteristic is permeability. Permeability, and again, this is a number which gives the characteristic of space which will allow magnetic field to be radiated, and for this he gave a sign mu, permeability. Okay, if it is for any material, it is mu. If it is for free space, then we give a notation mu naught. This is for free space. This is for any material medium or any medium. Okay, now it is spread in all the directions in the total angle, solid angle of 4 pi. So here in any one direction this will be 1 upon 4 pi. So this was dB equal to 1 upon 4 pi, that is in one direction, mu naught permeability by free space. This is a constant for free space, this is a constant for one unit direction, into this IDL sin theta upon R square. So we can write it, dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi IDL sin theta upon R square. This is magnitude of dB, and this is Biot-Savart's law. So Biot-Savart's law tells us that magnetic field depends upon so many quantities and constant of the medium. What is the name of this constant? Permeability. And what is its value? It has a certain value, like epsilon naught had a value. So this value we will study later, but for value purpose you can note it down, that mu naught upon 4 pi, this is equal to 10 to the power minus 7 units. Units we will study again. Okay, so if you want only mu naught, then mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 units. Okay, let's try to make the units here. For mu naught upon 4 pi, what should be the units? dB. dB has a unit Tesla. Tesla. R square, meter square, upon, this will go here, ampere. Per ampere. DL is again meter. Sin theta, no unit. So let's do the cancellation, and this is Tesla meter per ampere. Tesla meter per ampere is the unit of mu naught upon 4 pi. Four pi has no unit, so this is unit of mu naught, and that I will write here Tesla meter per ampere. Okay, so remember, this is also asked in examination sometimes. What is the unit of mu naught? Tesla meter per ampere. And with this, again, we will try to find out its dimension when we apply it in any force formula. Okay. We will leave that. So this is unit, this is permeability. Now again, what is permeability? Answer: permeability is characteristic of the medium which allows magnetic field to spread. Okay, more is the permeability, more will be the effect of magnetic field. Less permeability, then less force. So in nature, it is opposite to permittivity. More permittivity, less force. Here, more permeability, more is the magnetic field. Mu naught and epsilon naught, they have a very strange relation. Both are permittivity and they allow light to travel. So, we have a relation C is equal to 1 upon root mu naught epsilon naught. And you know what is C, velocity of light. So velocity of light in electromagnetic wave depends upon these two characteristics of the space. This is the relation mu naught epsilon naught C. Okay. So this is all about Biot-Savart's law. And now in the second lesson, now in the second lecture, we will see the characteristics of Biot-Savart's law, which are the salient features of Biot-Savart's law when we compared it to the Coulomb's law and the other laws. Thank you.